She's now 6'1", she's 39 years old. She played her indoor at High Point University. Left school ranked 5th in kills, that's right. 1,341 kills under her assassin belt. She's now 6'1", 29 years old. Give it up for the one and only, Christine L. Out of Barrington, Illinois. That's great. She's now 6'1" as well because H. Winsey's on a team. That's right. Height and quality. That's what we're all about here. She graduated high school in 2000. She graduated high school in 2023. Sweet dear Lord, and she's playing pro. A little bit jealous and a lot of hate throwing shade on you right now. She qualified for state in the 100 meter and the long jump.
Welcome, 2022 Wapaka Boat Ride, set number one underway here on Championship Court. That is going to be the combination of Held and Horwath with opening points here, 1-0. Horwath and Held both standing 6'1". Horwath actually a junior in high school right now. From Bennington. Right now, one kill for Horwath and one error gets us to 2-0. Held with the standing float, picked up by Molina. That was hard cross to the near side, touched, but unable to get a second favorable contact. Molina puts her team on the board, one serving two. Horwath handles. Molina, but very tight to the net. Hogan's second contact, unfortunately, goes underneath. Horwath back to the service line. The junior's been on the varsity indoor team for the last 3 years. Concluding her junior year, she'll start her senior year in the fall, taking a lot of opportunity here to compete, get a little bit better on the beach. She also qualified for state in the 100 meter and long jump. Crossbody pokey. Hogan ties this up 3 apiece. The Cape Girardeau product now residing in Pompano Beach, Florida.
multi-sport athlete in high school, playing 2 years of indoor at Miami-Dade College, and then 2 years. Side switch number one. Helt toes the service line. Over on two, but out of the reach or fingertips that she was aiming for and wide of that sideline. Four. Molina looking for the signal from Hogan. He's going to go cross court to Helt. Helt gets it. Helt.
We got 5-4 now.
Tough serve results in a bit of a scramble play. They were hoping they could recycle that one. Not able to that rally. Helt's tight. Horvath into the net. Service ace from Molina. It's going to bring us to 6-4. Continues going cross court. Helt. Horvath high. Her stat repertoire. Molina continues to serve. Handled by Horvath. First serve to Horvath. Picked up by Helt. Horvath on the run. Out of her reach. Sends that one into the banner. Lead open up to 4-8. Serving 4. Molina's fifth serve on the way. Helt's off. It's out of bounds, unfortunately. A timeout is requested, 1 point shy of the intermission. That timeout is requested by Helt and Horvath. Timeout concludes here on court number one. We're about halfway through set number one on court one of the Women's Open qualifier, the winner's bracket. Able to step close with that pokey across her body. Horvath back to serve. Hogan handles it. Molina goes overhead. Contacted by Horvath. Unfortunately, Helt not able to run that one down. I think she probably thought she had enough height on it.
had a good look, was outside the block, and a nice view of it, I think just out of her reach, hitting her hands and then going wide. Hogan to serve, choosing to go short. Helt's able to touch it, but out of the reach of Horwath. Hogan, the 28-year-old, standing 6'4", playing 4 sports in high school, all violation whistled against Helt. A lift is called. A catch is called. Hogan's going to continue to serve now with a 7-point advantage, 12-5. Horwath taken short. She's able to get it. Big rip, uncontested, to the top right of your screen. These teams looking to find themselves in the championship match tomorrow. That is going to give them an opportunity to take home a shot. Helt probably feeling a little bit better now. This is, you know, volleyball, much like in the indoor game, a game of runs. All things being equal, if you can get 2 3-point runs or more, you are 68% more likely. Now that is a sample size. Helt going off 1 foot over the top of Hogan to the sand. She's feeling a little bit better. 3-point swing, 2 points earned after the side out. This is going to be our intermission coming up next. Molina goes over. That's going to bring about our intermission. We're going to step away. We're going to take a look at our sponsors, which make this event possible for the AVP. This is the teams returning to the court. A little bit of a run here, making them feel a little more in contention. 9-12. Helt's going to continue to serve, going cross court to Molina. Big swing by Molina. To that point, has been hitting a lot of shots, showing that if you were going to serve me and not even attempt to block, I will take my pick of swings. What was once a 6-point advantage is now down to 4. Less a quick side out. Point.
points, 14-9 here in set number one. Make sure you're clicking that subscribe button, AVP America YouTube channel. Subscribe button. Stay tuned to all the events taking place over this schedule. A lot of volleyball still coming up as we're early in July. As I mentioned earlier, it is the fifth event for AVP. Kind of broken up into a few tiers. That's your majors, if you will. That's where all the big names and those who are able to finish here highly or have enough points will find themselves in that main draw, the first of which is coming up in August. This is the third tour event, so right below that. We also have a pro event of the year, which actually marks the sixth AVP event, is taking place concurrently in Hermosa Beach right now. You'll be able to head over to that YouTube channel, find the links corresponding to that event, and watch. Variety of reasons why teams might choose one over the other. Certainly a sight to behold here in Waupaca. That's going to bring about side switch number four, 17-10. Helt handles it. Porath over the top. Helt soft chop picked up by Molina. Hogan's going to put her tight. No one blocking. Going hard to the cross. That's going to be the bottom right of your screen. It's going to fall. It's going to bring us to the side switch number four. 18 serving 10 here in set number one. So if you're wondering, okay, how do I get into that main draw for those gold events? Couple of ways. One, having enough points. So once you take a look at the list for the main draw, they'll take a look at who those top people are, and if you have enough points, boom, you're in. The other way is coming to an event like this. Not only do you get points, you get those purse opportunities to help kind of continue the season and your training. Is if you're in the top four, so if you're in the semifinals, if you finish in that top four, you're going to find your way into the main draw as well. And so this one will feed into Manhattan Beach in August. I believe it's the 18th through the 20th. I'll confirm those dates here in just a brief moment. Lena back to serve. Now opening up to an 8-point advantage. Horath handles that one, puts held tight. Horwath's swing is intercepted, but picked up. Spot, unfortunately, just too far off the net as she was coming down, not able to play that second contact up to her teammate. Mariana Molina will serve at set point opportunity number one. Mariana looks for help. Help handles. Horwath. Of Horwath, that scores the 21st point here in set number one. Instagram, Facebook, maybe you like all three, maybe you just like one. Make sure you're watching us on YouTube. We're here for all of your viewing pleasures on your championship courts, and we'll talk to you very soon. Welcome back to court number one here in what is starting to become sunny Oshkosh, Wisconsin. Opening serve is wide of the near sideline. Mariana Molina back to the service line, hailing from Corte Madera, California. Potentially a favorable contact with the net by the ball causes that ball to fall out of the reach of Molina. We're all tied up, one apiece. Hogan's pass has had third contact out of the reach of Horwath. Cape Girardeau products back at the service line. Great topspin serve short and into the seam of Held and Horwath. Back to back service aces for Hogan. 4-1 here. Hogan and Molina took set number one. Got pretty close. They opened up a 5-point advantage at one point, being 12 to 5, so 7-point advantage. I apologize. But then Held and Horwath started chipping away. Serve causing a lot of pressure. Quick kill there by Held. She'll head back to the service line, cutting the deficit to two. Right now on the women's side, Caitlin Leary and Carly Kahn are the top seeds. It's only their third AVP. So her first contact is a result of Hogan contacting the ball, just not getting that one up where she would have liked. Molina to serve, handled by Horwath. It's going to be long of the end line. Hesitation. Looks as though Molina is going to add a service ace to her stat line for today's match. A similar location to Hogan, right in between. This time going short, Held handles it. Underneath the block of Held. That brings us 8-2, 6-point advantage. You might be hearing whistles in the background. There are four championship courts running simultaneously. Championship matches playing right now. We'll hopefully be able to bring you a view of the sight and spectacle that is Wapaka Boat Ride. There are courts as far as the eye can see. On the other side of the street is the camping location. People staying in tents or potentially a camper if they have that at their disposal. Teams leaning into the opportunity. Weather seems to be holding up nicely tomorrow. Feeling a little tight, needs your teammate to kind of help her stretch out a little bit. Hopefully nothing too serious. Thank you.
lead has been cut to 4. Right after the jump serve, the wind helps favorably. Though Hogan able to contact it, it's going to send it in the opposite direction of her teammate who's running towards the net. Back-to-back service aces, utilizing a different serve selection. The first time a top spin, the second with a jump float. They've been able to cut that lead down to 2, 8-6 on the second switch. But you can see as she's walking back, it looks like they might be looking to request a timeout.
Yeah,
potential.
Quad's really bothering her. Yeah.
Potential need for a little extra time. Medical timeout. We are going to step away. We're going to take a look at all of our sponsors, show you some sights, maybe some sounds of this beautiful day that's shaping up here on Friday, July 8th in Oshkosh, Wisconsin at the Wapaka Boat Ride 2022. We'll talk to you in just a little bit. Unfortunately, we are going to have a forfeit here in set number two. Molina and Hogan take it 2-0. Hogan and Molina take it. They will continue on. Horath and Helt are relegated to the contenders bracket.
At Corner Bakery, we're making your choice simple with choose two options every day. Choose two of your favorites and turn a simple lunch into a perfectly paired meal. And we're not talking about a few choose two options. Pair up any sandwich or panini, any cafe fresh salad or warm simmering soup, or any pan sauteed pasta. So many kitchen crafted options, so little time. Your perfect choose two combination is waiting at the Corner Bakery.
Those radio gym shorts that you have from college, they're done. Get them out of here. It's time to upgrade your short game with the one from Fabletics, man.
We love them. Your girlfriend will be stealing these. They're the best.
This fabric fixes another major issue, fit.
It's got this crazy stretch to it that looks so cute when I do my yoga or errands or like literally anything. They're the most comfortable, best feeling, luxe-tastic fabric that we have ever worn.